Well, hello friends. Today we're starting off in the garden, getting ready for my row cover. So behind me you see some big hoops. And a few years ago, I finally started adapting row covers after hearing about them for numerous years and never really taking the time to do it, thinking it was gonna be cumbersome. But it's such a nice organic way to simplify the worry of any type of insect on especially cole crops for me. So broccoli, cauliflower, cabbage, all those can be issues when you get the worms, when you get the moths, and it really starts wreaking havoc on those to the point where I know a lot of people don't grow broccoli because you're so worried, how do you not bring worms into the house? This is what we're really gonna tackle at the beginning here today. And really it takes maybe a little bit of work in the beginning, but then it's so much more simple. Light, air, rain, whatever you need still gets through the wonderful cloth. So what I'm using is a really simple, nice cloth. You can see here that it's super, super fine. But what that does is it keeps out any type of flying insect. But what it doesn't do is keep out any rain, which is really important for me. So what I'm gonna do is take you through the steps of what the plants look like now. If you remember in the beginning of the year, when I first plant them outside, I covered them with plastic jugs, kind of to act as a little greenhouse. And that protects them, it hardens them off, but also keeps anything away, kind of like the wind and everything. So what we're gonna talk about now is why they're at the point where they need to be done and what we can do to make sure they stay insect-free and we don't have to do anything once this is on. So you can see I'm already started putting some of these rows together or some of these big hoops. Now what I'm doing is removing the jugs and I'm gonna not have them up here anymore at all. I did have these wires I put in them then. Mine don't blow away, but my stepdad made these for me and they do work nice because he makes them for my mom too. What you can see is, now on some of them I removed them a few days ago because they're starting to get so big, they're gonna push on the sides of the container and eventually they'll get spindly if this is kept on for too long. So that's why I go around and remove these, which you can see how healthy and beautiful the plants are underneath. I mean, you can tell they just really are able to grow in such a nice protected environment, but if they get too big, they're gonna start crowding themselves out and not do near as well. So that's what I'm kind of watching for and I'm looking inside of them to make sure. Now, I think I did get just a little bit of frost damage a few weeks ago on the pieces that were touching the plastic, but all from the center is fine, so they'll grow out of that. It's a good time too to check any weeds. Now, what I will do before I put the row cover on is make sure my drip line gets pushed right up. There's a nozzle at each plant. Now what I do is I keep the end of it going outside of the row cloth, the cover, so I can make sure I can come and water it without having to push back the cloth if I don't want to. I'm using a different ring, or I should say, hoop this year. So it's a fiberglass one and it comes together in sections so you can adjust the size as needed. And I may need to take one out per because it kind of depends what size obviously your cloth is gonna be. It needs to be bigger. My cloth is a little over 6 feet wide and 33 feet long. These beds are 24 foot and you need that excess because it's going to go up and over and have to drape down and then you need to make sure you secure it. So these are nice because they just go together and then since they're fiberglass, they have some nice give and bend to them. So you're able to manipulate them into a nice hoop shape, which is really nice. And I'll show you here once I look at the right end. There's two ends that you can tell here have a nice point end and that's what goes straight down. So I'm gonna stick those right in to the soil. And then I will do one step over here so I can get to the other side easily as I put together this other end with a point at the end that I can then bend it. See how perfect? And now you can right away tell this makes a massive hoop and I may not need it near this big, but last year what happened was so many of the broccoli, cauliflower, all those things, they get really big and they were starting to push against because this was smaller. So with this taller one, I think it'd be really nice. Now, the one thing you're probably wondering about is wind. So I'm gonna talk about how I'm gonna try to secure it. But it's always a question for sure how well it's gonna do. Last year I tried pins and I didn't love how the pins worked because eventually with the wind, while it kept them in place, it also started ripping bigger holes into the cloth, which I don't wanna do. So I'm going to try to make sure I have enough room on the edges to be able to have a nice kind of T post or Y post or U post down here that will just hold it in place. And that's what I'm really hoping is gonna work. So I'm gonna put one more of these in, then we can start putting the cloth on. You can probably see why this could be better with maybe two people, but what I'm checking for right now is just my distance. And I do think it looks like I'm gonna wanna take one section out of each one. I could have measured this before, but why not do it with you guys? So you can see why this obviously is a really nice way to do it. Now, what you want to think about is protection, how you're going to make sure that it's not going to blow away. And so that's what I want to show you now. And I want to just stick these in a bit further so I have enough give here. And then I'm going to bring it a closer so you can see how I'm going to make sure this stays down, because I can get a lot of wind here. It just depends on the year and it depends on the weather, obviously. So I've been securing it around the bed here, and you can tell it has a little bit of give. That's why I like this fabric. And what I do is I make sure it has enough that I can set it down here. And then I take a heavy U-post. I use a U-post. And you can also, I know a lot of times I think like where you can order this from. I ordered mine from Renee's Garden. I don't think they tell you necessarily, but I think the packages a lot of times will tell you to kind of bury it a little bit. Obviously, if you're gonna have a lot of wind, that doesn't do much. So I like to make sure it's sitting under something heavy, like a heavy post. This is what I will put in sometimes with my tomato cages to make sure they don't blow over. And this all depends on what you have in your area, the weather you have. So what you want to do is make sure there's no holes, obviously, or gaps, I should say. And at the ends right now, eventually when I want to water, I'll bring out that hose end. For now, I'll probably just put some bricks here just to keep this down as wind could come. But now it's all secure. And it has a little bit of give to it. So as the plants do grow, they'll have room to be able to expand a little bit too within, it's not confining. I think that's the important thing. So now you can see bricks are holding it, posts are holding it on the sides, and it actually really protects everything. So this is what I've really been enjoying about this. And I talk about it in stories so often, and a lot of you have asked exactly how I use it and how I secure it. So this is what it is. Now, over the next few weeks, what's nice is, for no reason should I need to remove any of the fabric. If I do, I can put it back, but I can easily watch what's going on underneath. I can easily know how they're looking, if I need to do anything, and at that point, if I have to, I can of course then open it up and work with them as necessary. So after that garden work, I always feel like I want to do something fun, which is planting my hanging pots. Now, I got new hanging pots this year, and so I'm pretty excited about it. Last year, you know what, I'll just show you. I saved three of my hanging pots from last year, did not want to save them for the ferns that were inside, you're gonna see why, but I did save them for the succulents. Now, I've had these hanging pots for quite a while, but you can see last year, this is all beautiful succulent growth, just from 1 year on the front porch with a fern in the middle. Now it's a Kimberly Queen fern is what I usually plant. This one was usually Emerald Queen, which is a slightly smaller. And it just kind of, I think I had about a 12 or 14 inch pot. They were starting to get old, starting to get weathered, but they also just weren't quite holding the amount of soil and size I wanted to. So I upgraded to a 17 inch and it has a cocoa liner, which is this liner right here. But it has more of a antique, Victorian, and or European look, which is, I've been looking for these for a long time, so I found them on Kinsman, which I really like, is where I get my plant shelves usually for the plant room. What I like about them is they're simple. They're heavy grade, like powder coated steel, which I like. But what I wanna do is pot them up now with some really large ferns that I wanna put in this year. Now, the thing I feel I need to combat, I put these on the south side of the front porch, which we'll take them all over and I'll show you. But it gets a lot of sun, which the Kimberly Queen ferns do great every year for me. They can take that sun. But what usually in the past when I've used cocoa liner like this, the issue is it dries out for me. I don't know if any of you guys feel the same, but I feel like it dries out pretty easily. Now I'm gonna use my all-purpose potting soil. You know I love the Espoma potting soil because it's organic and it just has such a great, as I make a mess, it has such a great texture to it. Do you see that beautiful texture? It has perlite in it. You know, unlike some soils when you get them, that little white stuff you see is like fake styrofoam. I hate that. You want the real perlite. That's gonna be super important. Now, what I'm gonna do to combat that dryness that I'm worried about it drying out, because the cocoa, what it does is it drains really well, but it allows air through really well too, so a hanging pot can dry out. I'm going to use soil moist. Now, this is a little granular, which you can see here. I think it's honestly what maybe they put in diapers. And it doesn't take much at all. But what you can do, I've used this in the past and I kind of haven't used it for a few years because I haven't needed to. You just put a small amount. Now it tells you on the back of the package, the soil is not sponsored. It's just something I happen to have and I'm excited to use it in these to hopefully help. It takes a very small amount. I'm putting 2 teaspoons in these large 17-inch hanging pots. You mix that in. What it does is that little pieces, they hold on and suck in moisture and then they keep it. And so it slowly releases that moisture into the container. So honestly, I think it should work pretty well. What I'm gonna do though is use large ferns to start with. I'm kind of tired of having puny little starts. And I know a lot of people buy big ferns to start. I have never been able to find around where I live Kimberly Queens already in hanging baskets. I only find them in these pots like I have right here, which you can tell they are very well grown because they're hard to get out of the container, which I'm just squeezing around. See what I'm doing? I'm squeezing it as I turn it because that helps pull it right off. But you can see, look at all of that growth. Now, if I wanted to, I could split these. Don't ever be afraid to split them. Growing up, mom would split plants all the time and it would allow you to have multiple. But you know, in this case, I want it to really feel like it's growing already. I feel like other years, I wait all summer long. And finally, by the end of summer, when we're about getting too cold, I have a full hanging pot. So in this case, what I'm gonna do is start with a nice big start, as you can see. I'm just gonna stick it right in here. And what's nice is that soil moist, that's what it's called, soil moist. Since I'm already in the soil, it's gonna do its job too. Now what I'm gonna do is just put more soil around it. And then what I'm gonna do, since I saved all those succulents from last year, and this is why I saved them, I'm gonna take them out of the pot. And these are so easy. So I save these year to year. And do you see how they're long? Instead of planting them fully long like they are, I cut them up, I just rip them apart. This is, I think, string of bananas, if I remember right. It's a Senecio. And I'm gonna stick them in the pot, and then where I just kind of rip them in half, I'm gonna take little pieces and dry root them. This is what I do every year. And this is what allows me to have so many of these succulents growing out of these containers. So I'm gonna stick them in here. I have a total of 5 to do because I already have one up on the front porch. Then we're gonna take them all up. But you're gonna see, I personally think this size container works so much better with the scale of the front porch and just with looking much more full to begin with. I just got ready to do the second one and I forgot. I like to use biotone in it too. You know, honestly, you know I use this in most things. It's just a great starter, but it's a nice thing to make sure these get acclimated really quickly. If you don't remember, it's okay, but when I remember, I like to make sure I throw it in. Now, if you want more of a long-term fertilizer, you could put some Hollytone. Ferns happen to like Hollytone, which is a nice acidic fertilizer for things like ferns. But you could also just do, you know, a really easy all-purpose fertilizer every time you water. Nothing in these is gonna be heavy blooming, so I'm not worried about blooming fertilizers or bloom boosters. It's more of a just a nice, general, healthy, nitrogen-rich fertilizer because you just want the beautiful green growth. I have all the ferns I just planted loaded here. So it's 5 plus the one I did the other day. Now you can see they're nice and big, which is what I really like, but they have a lot of weight then to them too. So you kind of have to think about what size you can handle if you need to move them around a lot. Now, they come obviously with super heavy duty chain, which is really important. And now you could adjust the size too if you wanted to, as far as, you know, how far down it's gonna hang. But right now I think it's just, so usually I use clips or like little hangers that made my last ones hang down further. But since these are larger, I really don't think I'm gonna need to. So I'm gonna hang them up. We'll kind of check the sizing of them, the placement, water them, and we'll be good. I'm finishing up watering them all, and you can see they're really big containers, so obviously they're gonna hold a lot of water. But I'm hoping too that means that soil moist and everything will be able to really counteract the cocoa, which I love the look of the cocoa liner. Don't think I don't, because it's actually one of my favorite looks. I've just always found it dries out quicker. Row cover and hanging pots all together. Now, remember, the row cover you can adjust for any size garden you have. If you have a small raised bed or even in-ground gardening or larger, you can adjust the sizes to need. You can just cut it up if you need to, even for smaller pieces or smaller lengths. Hanging pots, same thing. Adjust to the size you need. Now, you're probably wondering, why do you always put your pots together? A lot of people buy their hanging pots. You know, when I was younger, that wasn't even a thing. And I think the one thing I don't like about buying a pre-done hanging pot, usually they're so grown by the time you get them, that when you bring them home, they don't have near as long a season. You have to cut them a lot or maintain them and prune them back so they keep fleshing out new growth. When I pot my own like this, they still have a lot more room to grow into, and they have a whole season ahead of them. And already this year, since I'm starting with larger 17-inch pots, they look really nice and sizable even to begin with. So that's what I'm excited about. That soil moist, I will keep you updated in my stories and in successive videos as I do tours telling you how it's working. I'm hoping it's good. Otherwise, on the south side, these are gonna be drying out all the time. So I really hope not. So let me know if you've used those products like soil moist, if that works for you, I'd love to know. And until then, enjoy something beautiful in your garden. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna finish watering and enjoy this beautiful air. I'll probably eat outside tonight too.